So, don't see nothing, man.
Hi there. Gray here again. And new review. I've got some, well, quite a lot. I mean, probably hundreds of males over these 2 years now. The newbies and guys wanting to start doing archery, wanting me to review a cheaper bow that's not like 5,000 plus crowns. And well, to be honest, I haven't I've had a bit of a hard time finding something that I really like to shoot with it. Mostly because they are, well, not that good made, and they have not enough reflex deflex, so it takes away the hand shock. And well, I got a bow that really changed everything, man. This is a Wild Mountain Kailash, 68 inches, and this is at 50 pounds at 28. And so, okay, if it was a real expensive custom bow, I would expect it to have the performance that this one really has. It's insane. But a bow for 3,000 crowns, shooting and behaving like it is, because there's no hand shock. Okay, it's not the fastest. I haven't shot it through a chrono, but I guess something around 165, I don't know. But, well, you know, you who know me know that I don't care about speed, I just want precision, and it really has precision, absolutely, top notch. And the handle is perfect. It has a bit thick limbs, but okay, it's very narrow, so it must have thick limbs. It's four layers of ash, and ash is a very light wood, so you can expect it to be very light. And I don't know, it just, man, it shoots like anything else I've been shot with. So, and it's so smooth to draw, because that is also something with these cheaper bows, that they can start stacking. And stacking is something that occurs, like this bow is made at 50 pounds at 28. So if I draw it longer, because a bow should, like say from 26 inches up to 27, 28, 29, it should kind of increase in weight around the same, 2.5 to 3 pounds all the way for every inch you draw it longer. If you got stacking, it means that the bow, let's say from 29 to 30, instead of going up like 2.5 or 3 pounds, it goes up 4 or 5 pounds, and that's stacking. It stacks. It becomes very heavy to draw, and there's no stacking at all at this bow. I mean, Peter shot it. He's shooting like 31 inches, but man, it's so soft. Incredible. Oh god, I got a pain in my shoulder. Injured myself at work. So I'm gonna take you on a little stumping tour, short one, because as I said, I got a pain in my shoulders, can't shoot that much, but I just wanted to show you this bow, because of course this is a review. It's gonna be a little bit short review, but I mean, this is, it's mind-blowingly good. I don't know, what can I say, man? It's just, to be honest, I shoot as good as this with this as anything else. And okay, when I shoot those 40 plus meters stump shooting, of course the arrow's trajectory is much, much lower than my Acadian, but the Acadian is incredible with that. So, but it took a while, and man, my brain started to adjust. It wasn't a problem. And okay, occasionally I got those low shots, but if I just continue shooting with it, or if I was a beginner or anyone else that kind of bought this bow from the beginning and start shooting, it wouldn't be a problem, because your brain's gonna adjust to the arrow's arc. So, man, so let's go for a few shots. I think you see the stump there. See if I can see. Today's cold shot. See if I put something upper to the left. Yep.
Oh, that was a nice one.
Saw that?
Too bad I didn't have the SGH, because that just breaks them and still flies kind of straight. So. But I mean, it's like, okay, it got black limbs and it's not, doesn't have the bling bling. And, but man, what do you want from a bow? I mean, the first thing you want is it to perform good and shoot straight. And well, it can't perform and shoot more straight than it does. So,
what can I say, man? But okay, I can't even start to compare this with bows like Acadian and the beauty of a Falco that is not that expensive. And Falcos, of course, looking better, they are faster. And but if you start thinking about what you get the value for money, man, this is the bomb. It's just, because the thing is that this is a ready-made bow, so this is not a custom or nothing. You just order it, and a few days later you get it, so you don't have to wait for ages to get it. So let's see if we can get that. I found a stump there. Trying to find new angles. I don't think you see that. Trouble with this screen is crappy actually in the sunlight, because I can't see what I'm looking at, to be honest. I think it's somewhere. Is this yeah. I think that's the one. I'll go down low and see if I can hit that one. So, and the feeling shooting with it, it's kind of wonderful. So, oh, I got a lot of stuff in my way. I got a lot of branches. I'm gonna shoot the SGH first and see if I can take off some twigs there. Me and Peter really love those points, man. The only fault they have is that the arms are a bit too long, so I reckon they're eventually gonna break. And just thinking, maybe make shorter arms and make four of them. And with some more back support, man. With the same design, cutting design, is that the ultimate stump point, guys? You see, I'm hitting the branches every time, but he still goes and hits the stump. Except that one. So, I just can't believe it, how it behaves. And the first thing Peter said when I shot with it, he stand beside me, it is how quiet it was. But okay, I brace height tuned it, and I put some, because I was like a bit soft with my arrows, so I put some string silencers on it, and it became perfect. So, one arrow gone. This is the fun part, eh? No. So, guys, and it's not bad looking, is it? In the sunshine. And you know, those black limbs, they look kind of good.
they're kind of matte. They're not glossy. It's like matte black. So, what can we more find here? If I can shoot it, everything is... there's something in the way for everything I try to shoot. This is just... this is the stump heaven, by the way, and... it is in springtime so fantastic, because... well, the grass haven't grown up. So you can really see all the stumps, man. Oh! And this is not even the best part. I mean, you can see the stumps like everywhere, but if you go higher up, man, this gets nuts, man. They're absolutely everywhere. So that was a big rock. So can we do something here? I have a funny one up here. But man, it is so crappy to try to find what I'm looking at. I think it's there, yeah. And of course I got a lot of twigs and stuff. I think I'm gonna put this behind me and try to film me shooting. There it is, eh? Shooting a SGH too close to the other arrows is not a good idea. I met Matty just the other week and he said that he broke two arrow shafts right straight through with the SGH. And it does. It really cuts twigs and arrows like nothing, man. So 2-2. And this is not only the stump forest. Man, this is moose forest. I probably say elk sometimes when I... because moose is älg in Swedish, so it's easy to say it wrongly. But elk is something else in English. So moose, there are so many moose tracks, and I found a shed last year. Can we have something? That's a funny one. Oh yeah, I like those itty bitty. That's not too easy to... let me put it behind. Well, that is an awkward camera position. And as usual, I don't know if it's in the picture. Yeah, I think I got it now in the middle there. Yeah, I think so. These are soft, right through. A bad wind coming from the left here. It's not usually blowing here. Just make big holes in the stump. So guys, so to be honest, if you're a beginner and you buy this bow, I think it would take a long time before you even recognize that there are expensive boats out there, because it just feels kind of ticks all the boxes of what you want from a good shooting bow, because that is what it is, mate. Absolutely fantastic. It's just a bit of a mind blow, to be honest. I can't. I have a hard time digesting it, even, because it is really that good. I got a stump behind there I want to get a crack at bump. It's not easy. Let's do some bush shooting, as we call it. We shoot through bush. Just don't know again if you see there's a stump here somewhere. No, it is, I think, there. Through the thickness. And this is the fun thing with the SGA, just you can shoot through twigs and things with it, because it just cuts them like a knife and continues straight. Or at least kind of. But if you shoot a judo, the arms are gonna be caught in the twig or branch, and it just deflects to kind of any side here. Oh, I completely missed it. That go right through. It's a softy. And this is the thing with the stump pellet. They are so soft, man. There are very few hard ones here. But I got them too. So this is an interesting shot. So I gotta shoot just above and under to be able to hit it. So I'm learning trajectory. Ah, it's this one. I think this one of the stumps on my seven arrows zombie run. Was a softie, eh? So guys. And the thing is that I really don't know. I'm starting to get a bit curious about. I could just adjust the camera. Does it have that fine precision? Is it even possible to have that fine precision as I have with my Acadia, the more expensive custom bows? Because, but I made some pretty incredible shots when I was up with Peter. That blew both mine and his mind, because. But I haven't target shot or butt shot the targets and really see how it kind of gathers the shots, because. Well, but I have to say that shooting four arrows in the same stump, I really have to look at different places, because it really. It's going to destroy my arrows otherwise, so. It really is fantastic, and as I said, that it's not as fast as my Acadian is. I'm shooting the exact same arrows. A bearshafted shot, the bearshaft that I shoot with the Eugenia at like 46 pounds, and so this at 50 is not as fast. But, well. As I said, I don't really care, man. As long as I hit what I'm looking at. That's just the main thing, so. What can I say, man? So the Wild Mountain Kailash, 68 inches, 50 pounds at 28. It actually comes from Bignami in England. Italy. Bignami in Italy. And this particular one comes from jackbogen.se.
And I would say it wouldn't make anyone proud, to be honest. I mean, I shot a few really nice bows, and I just can't say that this is a cheaper one when I'm shooting it. Because, of course, if I'm looking at it, the thick limbs, but okay, they're thick because they're so narrow. So, I mean, with the black snow cocoa bowl, but this nice, looks like zebra wood, and Zebrano, and it looks like Shedwo or something in the middle here. And man, I don't know, it's just so well made, it's faultless. There's just not an angle, anything that's not been sanded. And it has a very funny inward sanded edges that just kind of gives it more appealing look. And man, I just can't believe it. 3,000 crowns. And as I said, this is just a ready-made bow. You can just order it. So, man, like the Falcos, I think that is wonderful, man. You can just go on the internet and just order a bow. That's a real shooter, to be honest. So, love that. And I hope to find more of these bows, because they have some nice, Wild Mountain have some nice recurve, three-piece recurves. It would be nice to try them too, so. Well, you never know. So guys, I gotta continue back to my car, shoot some stumps, go home. I feel my elbow, I need to rest. Because we shot a lot on Sunday, and I had a bit of a bad elbow then too, so I should probably rest a week, but man, that's a hard thing to do when the sun is shining. Ray's got a bow in his hand. But guys, see you out here in the forest. Take care. So what, guys, I gotta tell you something more. Because it's not that fast. And I shoot in like 30 inch, 55, 55s, so 500 spine at 30 inches. That means that my arrow is gonna hold up for longer, because it's not that fast and powerful. Because, well, I'm not gonna hunt with this one, this is stumping. But at 50 pounds, it will still probably stop, well, just under beneath moose and elk. Whitetail, no problem at all. And small javelina pigs too, probably without problems. But for me, the magic, the good thing is that it's not that fast and it doesn't punch that hard. And something that I noticed is that if the arrows are longer, if you hit something really hard, like a, well, a rock hard stump or even a rock, if the arrow is a bit longer, it kind of bends and gets a bit more forgiving. And it doesn't crack in the back end or in the front end, because it's allowed to bend. Somehow it seems like it does do that. A longer arrow, even if it's a bit heavier, kind of stands better against the punishment of a complete stop. I don't know why, or man, that's just, it just really seems to be that way. So me thinking, okay, it's a heavier arrow, should have more punch, but the bow is slower. So so these 30 inch 55 35 55s, I've yet to break one, to be honest. And I've shot the Eugenia that's faster too with these arrows, but they seem to take anything, man. So, and well, around 55 to 50 pounds. It seems kind of like an ideal arrow for stumping, so just thought you might want to know that. See you.
Me again, I can't stop shooting. My elbow's aching. Just having too much fun. There's a stump in there. And the thing also with this, it doesn't really have any hand shock because it has a nice reflex deflex kind of form, and that is absolutely wonderful because I gotta go.
I mean, some guys say that, well, their bow has a bit of a hand shock, but it doesn't matter. But well, if you shoot like I do, man, thousands of arrows probably every month, and I mean thousands of arrows, you're gonna get a problem here. There's a bit here that's gonna get infected and it's gonna hurt every time you shoot, and you come to a certain point you can't shoot at all, and it can take, man, it can take 6 months to get rid of that. So that is something you never get if you get a bow with a nice reflex deflex curve that takes away the hand shock. So that's not a problem for you. You don't have to think about overshooting or shooting too much. So this is gonna be an Indian shot. Ooh, it looks so soft. It was so hard. Because it's just a joy to shoot with a bow that doesn't have any reflex deflex, guys. So I would say that is the first thing. Oh man, that was a good thing. That's the first thing I want with my bows. I don't want any hand shock. So I'm looking for a really nice reflex deflex form, and I don't know, maybe some of you are thinking, what's a reflex deflex form? So I'll show you. I was about to put down the camera. This sharp edge, the angle here shows that it's reflex deflex. If it doesn't have a reflex deflex, if it's a straight bow, it's gonna go more like a D, like this. So you can actually see it here. And I can take it down so you can see. It has some really nice curves. And those curves, reflex, deflex, kind of takes out the hand shock completely. So just behaves more, what can you say, nicely. First arrow didn't get stuck with SGA, no? It's like cellulose, man. Like paper. I don't use those tassels to clean my arrows. I don't want to be carrying a tassel or something. So what I do with my arrows, if I got some wooden things on, I do like this. It's a good brush. Oh, one of the judo arms broke off. And that is mostly what happens with these judos. And judo with three arms, it's starting to get real crappier. This SGH, even with a point broken, I really can't see the difference in its behavior. It still stops, and it stops straight too, so. But it has the little problem of breaking off. So I really don't know. If I hope you're gonna see me there. So I know G5 made this as a small game head, but man, you guys, you know, stumping is like a fever all over the world. It's growing probably most in the trad shooting community, and making this with a bit shorter arms
more support from the back and make four of them in a cross. That would absolutely be the best thing ever for stump with. And of course it would be probably as good or even better, I don't know, as a small game head. So why not, guys? Because you do this to sell them, man. Make money. You gotta make more money. If you include all the hunters and all the stumpers, man. Oh, I gotta quit that shooting my own arrows, man. I'm just showing off. No, I usually shoot 2-3 arrows, but like Sunday, I think I shot 4 on every stump. It was just that fun. Because the thing is that I was supposed to film our little stumping adventure, mine and Peach's, but it was just so much fun. We couldn't stop shooting and we found a new bit of a forest we usually be in, close to Peter where he lives, and man, there was stumps everywhere. It was like, it was a pretty much like stump heaven too, so we really didn't film anything. We just shot for hours and hours and we had so much fun. And I got an aching shoulder to prove that. So guys, once again, Wild Mountain Kailash from Bignami, Italy, and jaktbogen.se. Check it out, guys. But you who know me, I'm just gonna see if it's on, yeah? You who know me, I'm gonna raise the camera a bit. Know that I shoot with my Cadian, I love it a lot, cause it has a special feature, it's the shelf. And it has an absolute center shot. My arrow is in the absolute middle of the bow. And of course so is the Eugenia. And when I shoot, this is cut to center. I don't use anything on it now, because, well, it just shot that good as it was. And with the arrows I had, so I haven't done anything yet. But the big difference between a, well, not cut to center or a true center shot trad bow is, for me, if I glance at the arrow and the bow, I'm gonna show you what it does, what the difference is. It's kind of very obvious to me when I'm shot as much as I da doing with this one. If we take something, we need to have a target. Let's say I'm shooting at that tree. So if I was to glance at my arrow and my bow when I'm shooting my Acadian, it would more or less look something like this. The arrow is kind of like going there, straight towards the target. But when I'm shooting not center cut bows, it's like it goes a bit more like this. And it looks like I'm gonna miss, but more center shot it is. It's like it's getting more and more towards the target when I see it. And if I really tilt my head too, and the less cut out it is, it's like more or less going to look like this. And it's like I see the arrow sideways. And if you're not a real dedicated instinctive shooter that only look at the target and don't look at the arrow or the bow, so if you kind of glance at it, you are going to adjust that and you're going to shoot to the right. So that could be a bit hard, but in real situation, in real life, it really doesn't matter. The only thing that really cut out absolute center shot bow is going to give you is more speed, more power, and be more forgiving. But
Well, as I'm shooting with this bow, it's fantastic. And it's only cut to center, so my arrow is laying to the left of the center quite a bit. So it is, because I'm so used to shooting instinctively, I don't mind, I just don't care about the bow and the arrow, I don't mind them. I just look at my target, and that doesn't really matter for me anymore. It did a few years back. I had a hard time shooting bows that was not cut sent or was center shot. Or I shot so much better with them, but I just trained myself to ignore it, just look and point and shoot. Because I do the bear shaft testing at home, and I do that from around like 3-4 meters. And when my bear shaft hit the hole of my arrows, I know I'm gonna hit whatever with it. Because I mean, I've been doing this for 20 years, 23 years plus, and I know that when I bear shaft my arrows like that, they're gonna go straight for me. So it really doesn't matter, to be honest. So, but I do like it if they are at least cut to center, and if they are at least 1/8 of an inch past center, marvelous, man. And if they are absolute center shot with the arrows, so you can tune in your shelf so you can get the arrows absolutely in the middle. Fantastic. Absolutely the best there is. So, but it's not a must. And all these bows that are ready made, very few of them are even cut to center. They are less than that. And this one seems to be cut to center. And I don't know if it's because of that, but it really performs beautifully, absolutely. Fantastic. So, it's gonna be a long film. I'm still here. I don't know if it's on, because I have a real hard time seeing this damn display. It's making me nuts, man. Is it on or is it not? I think it's on. So guys, so after like, I don't know, 1.5 hour, was supposed to be 20-30 minutes, but it was just too much fun once again. And really, already nicked it. Yeah. It really performs like anything, man. I just can't believe it. Looks good. It's black. It's a bit brighter from the side, but wonderful. Wild Mountain Kailash. Dang, incredible. So one thing I thought I'll tell you, I thought of now when I put my arrows back in the car. Thing is that I kind of used 3555s, 500 spine GTs to all my bows, because I figured out that I want to, with a little slower or lower in poundage bows, a little longer arrows, but the same spine. So if I break them, I can just cut off a bit and shoot with my Acadia. And, well, I really don't break them, the longer ones, so, but I still cut most of them. I only got these 4 to stump shoot with. I got 3 arrows, target arrows. But I only got these 4 arrows now left. But the thing is that I can cut these down, shoot my Acadian. If I break them in the front or in the back, I can still cut them. I can put a long insert in the arrow and cut them really short and still use them for my Acadian. And when I'm cutting off a bit of the shaft, I'm taking out some weight. So the weight increase that I have from the long insert compared to the standard insert
doesn't really do that much for the arrows, but okay, I haven't tried them on really far distances, but it doesn't really seem to matter. So I kind of used them in three steps, I mean the same arrow, so yeah, I can tell you it's blowing, yeah. So I got like, I think I got 36 arrows with long inserts at home. So I got a lot of short arrows with long inserts for my Acadia, and I still got, I think, what is it? Well, I don't think I have more than 7 arrows left full length with my Acadia. So something to think about, that maybe you can use the same arrows that you thrashed. Just cut off a piece, put on the long insert, and bash off them. And well, you can probably use them too, so who knows, guys. I use them in 3 steps, the same arrows. So, but I need some more full length 35-55s. So I can shoot with the Kailash. See you guys out here in the forest.